smile. You're all I've ever wanted, and my arms are open wide.
I wanna be a billionaire so bad, buy all of I never had.
Welcome to the board meeting. I'm very proud of my crew members and their abilities to make this park safe. So how did you guys do it?
At the first time, we failed.
Why?
Because our roller coasters weren't fast enough to finish the loop.
What is the minimum velocity for the roller coaster to go around?
First, the roller coasters travel in a circular motion. At the highest point of the roller coaster, centripetal force is provided by force of gravity and normal force.
You were saying two forces are acting on it?
Yes, but in order to find the minimum speed of the roller coaster, we have to make the centripetal force as small as possible. That leaves only force of gravity providing the centripetal force.
So no normal force?
As shown in the diagram, centripetal force is provided by force of gravity and force of normal. In this case, force of gravity equals centripetal force, so mg equals m times v squared over r. So for velocity equals square root of acceleration of gravity times radius.
The minimum speed for a roller coaster to complete a circle is root gr at its highest point.
Yes, but our first roller coaster speed was way smaller.
That's it?
Then we added magnets into the tracks, making centripetal force less, so that the minimum velocity for a roller coaster to go through the loop is less than that Sunny just said, therefore much safer. According to the diagram, creating magnets on the track provides a force that points outwards, force of magnet. This reduces the centripetal force, which reduces the speed needed to go through the loop.
Okay, we're done. That's a great meeting. Thank you for coming.